So back here with the vote with Andrew Kay, creative director and latest TV presenter, and we're going from London to Brighton. How did you first end up in Brighton? And I know there's a few stories to tell there, isn't it? Because I know you've been involved with the latest for a number of years now.
Well, I moved to Brighton when I was 31. I signed the deeds for the house I was buying the day that the storm blew down everything. So I was in London thinking, oh my God, I won't have a house when I get back there, because that terrible storm was pretty devastating. But I was lucky and I did. And I moved down and commuted for quite a few years, which, you know, when you're in your 30s, commuting's not so terrible. I wouldn't want to do it now. But I started picking up a magazine called The Punter, which was the Brighton version of Time Out, really. And it was great. I loved it. 5 years on, I was made redundant, very unceremoniously, by Macmillan, and ended up in the newspapers because it was done without Lord Stockton being told. So Lord Stockton's son used to come and work for me in his vacations from Eton, and he turned up to work for me one day and I wasn't there. And he went to see his father and he said, look, Andrew's not here. So Stockton got on the telephone, where's Andrew? What's happened? So he was then told that they'd made me redundant. He was furious. And the gossip columnists got hold of the story and I ended up a full story, you know, half a page in the papers with a photograph of me, which my mother was horrified because I was at the House of Lords with Stockton. And I'm looking quite smart, except that if you scanned right down the picture, you could see I was wearing shorts, which I was quite famous for in publishing as the art director who wore shorts.
Was that reversed at all? He would have had the power to reverse it, wouldn't he?
No, it wasn't reversed. Right. No, I wouldn't have gone back. It was a horrible situation and not one that I would ever want to go back to. And also, you know, after 16 years designing, you know, probably 200 book covers a year for 16 years, you've probably got it out of your system, and I wanted to do different things. And I was floundering around for a while, but I still picked up The Punter every week to find out what was going on, or every month in those days, what was going on. There was a restaurant columnist in it, and I'd been crazy about food, having worked in a hotel when I left school and becoming chef by default, and coming from a food background with a grandmother who was a confectioner and grandfather who was a butcher. So food was a passion. So I wrote to a man called Bill Smith, who was the editor, and said, your food columnist, your restaurant reviewer, is terrible. He doesn't know anything about food. He just knows about eating in restaurants.
Okay, brilliant. We're going to leave it there. So that's it with Andrew Kay. All the best for the future. I know we're going to be catching up pretty soon and speak soon. Take care. Thanks.